ओम श्री गणेशाय नमः, ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। Have you ever been in the situation where you have felt you've been taken for granted by your own family or by your friends or by your colleagues at work or your subordinates or your boss? I come across people who are housewives and who would say things like, my husband takes me for granted, and you know, he assumes that I have all the time in the world to do everything, and I'm meant to do only this and only that. At the same time, I also have senior colleagues coming and telling me that, you know, their senior management thinks, you know, just because they pay them high salary, you know, they are at their disposal and they just have to keep doing work, and you know, no matter what time of the day it is and things like that. I also have ladies complaining that their own brothers and sisters and family members, parents also take them for granted, and they just use them in the sense, it could be financially or it could be like their services, or they take their help and not return the same help when it's really time that they need something from them. So all this is happening because in your chart, your Lagna Lord will be very weak, or your Lagna Lord will be with the 6th house Lord, some influence of the 6th house Lord, or you will also have the Rahu's Drishti on the Lagna Lord. All this is creating a kind of weakness for your chart, because one thing is you are attracting negative Drishti on you, Naradrishti we call it. In many chart, when I do the readings, I tell them that. And when you and your enemies are together, sometimes it becomes hard. You know, it's like if there's something very close to your vicinity, you lack clarity in vision, right? If it is at a certain distance, you get comfortable and you're able to see that. The same thing happens here. What happens is that you're not able to see clearly who's good, who's bad. You just believe everybody and you think they're your family, your friends. So, you know, why would they misuse me? Nothing like that. I'm supposed to be the one, when, you know, the friend in need for them. I am the family. I'm the one they should rest on, and things like that. And then we just go out of the way to help them, and we feel so good helping, and end of the day we feel like, wow, I've really made a difference to this person's life. Now this is a good illusion, this is a good thought, also it's good dharma and karma, because you're helping somebody in need. But you'll know the true colors when you are in need, when you are at your lowest ebb. Are they ready to help you? That is when most of my clients have had eye-opening experiences and also heart-shattering experiences, I can say. They come back to me and say their own family has really ditched them and let them down, and their friends who were supposed to be friends are now avoiding their phone calls, not helping them at all. Very, very bitter experiences, very sad experiences. And you know, I just want to tell you that you're not alone. I mean, this is happening everywhere. So first word, one thing I want to warn you is, just because I always advocate people to help each other, that doesn't mean you don't use your discretion and you just blindly help. Help within your limits. Help if possible. Don't do something where you're helping somebody at your cost. That is never going to help you, because when you need it, you never know if that person is really going to help you back or not. This is one thing I want to tell you. Second thing is that, what is the remedy for this? Because such astrological charts will only attract such situations. I'll tell you another situation, a classic case where you would probably be used for money. If your second house is occupied by a third house Lord, or if your second house Lord and third house Lord are together, lot of times what happens is people will be associated with you only for your money. They'll praise you, they'll boost your ego, they'll make you feel good on top of the world, and they'll be doing all of this just to make sure that they use you for money when they really need you. And when that happens, they just let go of you. Now, how do you deal with this situation? Like, how do you avoid people from taking you for granted? How do you protect yourself from making sure that nobody does this again? You're not like a food truck being you're not a tissue paper to use and throw. How do you do that? One, of course, we treat the problem at the planetary level. You have to address that. I've always told you, you cannot ignore the planets. And being an astrologer, I would definitely hold any planet at their highest esteem, because each planet has a role to play. And it's not just one planet creating problems. One planet will be in the forefront and the other planets will also be instrumental in pushing the whole situation to that. So now what do you do then? How do you deal with this? We have a very powerful puja called the Batuk Bhairav Puja. Okay, now that this is a Mahapuja which we do, wherein we are invoking the Bhairava, but the aspect of Bhairava is not Kala Bhairav or Unmata Bhairav or Ananda Bhairav, it is Batuk Bhairav. So Batuka is basically actually Vatu. Vatu is the word. So Vatu means a boy, okay, not even a juvenile, I would say somewhere in between 10 to 14 years old, that age group. Okay, so that age, the aged, that is the age limit, and that aged Bhairav is called Batuk Bhairav. So the North Indians and somewhere some parts of Bengal, they call it Ba. Va is always Ba. So they say Batuk Bhairav. So now even all of us, we say the same thing, Batuk Bhairav, Batuk Bhairav. So now this Batuk Bhairav is a very powerful form of Bhairava, and we have a very famous temple of Batuk Bhairav in Kashi also. All the Bhairavas are there in Kashi actually, and Batuk Bhairav is also quite a famous powerful temple. Bhairav has a very different kind of anushtan, a tantric anushtan, and Batuk Bhairav anushtan, attaining siddhi of that is very difficult, because he is very playful at one side. He'll test the sadhak, you know, how serious you are and things like that. He'll sometimes scare them also, and only when they show their consistency in sadhana and their commitment towards sadhana to get the siddhi, he blesses them. And once this happens, what he actually does is he gives them the siddhi to achieve whatever they want. Okay, so basically these siddhi purushas don't want anything for themselves. They take sankalpa on behalf of others and they pray for us. So it's like that. So when I'm talking about the Batuk Bhairav sadhana anushtan, maha anushtan, so what really happens in this is we take sankalpa on behalf of our clients. So the sankalpa will be such that, you know, it gives some power to their personality so that people hesitate to take you for granted. See, now if there are two people, you may be the weak one, they are the strong one. So you may not have a tendency to take that person for granted, because you feel, this person cannot be taken for granted, he's very strong and he's shrewd and he's powerful. That's how you feel. He may just be an ordinary person, but you won't take him for granted. That's because his persona is like that. Now, Batuk Bhairav and Maha Anushtan will make your persona like that, so that people don't take you for granted. You are very much respected and you valued for what you are, who you are, what you do. This is one thing. Second thing is, it's also very useful for attracting wealth. Because Batuk Bhairav is like a small child, he's like Subramanya Swami. Okay, so youngster, so very fast in action, very quick in getting results, and very, very attractive to attractive energy, I can say, not for anything else. So the energy is so attractive that when you reach out to that energy, the energy is very benevolent and he'll bless you if you are deserving. But to get to the deserving stage only, you need to do so many sankhyas of jap and anushtan. But that we can define it when I look at a chart, I know how many sankhyas of jap is required for you. And then I can probably recommend what is the best sankhya for you for Batuk Bhairav. But Batuk Bhairav is definitely there to protect you, protect your wealth, generate wealth for you, create opportunities for you. He's an amsha of Lord Shiva. And he can give you anything you want. So, but we have to be very wise in asking what we want. So that is how it is. So one thing is, he definitely eliminates the negativity and lack of power of the planets, and he empowers the planets. Second thing is, he also bestows with great opportunities to create wealth and to create a good community for yourself, like a good surrounding, good set of people around you, so that you're not taken for granted, you're valued, you feel important, and you're genuinely considered important. Now all these things are taken care of by Batuk Bhairav only. So the Maha Anushtan is very powerful. Make good use of this, and if you are facing the issues which I mentioned about, you can reach out to me. I have had clients who just feel so taken for granted when their parents tell them to close the door and get them a glass of water and things. Even for that, they feel like, I'm being treated like a servant. I'm now 40 plus years old, and why am I still being treated like a kid? And people are nowadays facing these kind of issues. So now I'm not talking about such trivial issues, but I'm talking about issues which have been there for ages. Like, thankless jobs you've been doing for your family, your friends, and your office, and you're not rewarded adequately. Over and above, you're cheated, and you're not being helped when you need. that empowered feeling is not there in you anymore. So that is something that he can restore back to you, Bhattabhairav. So definitely you should pray to that form of Lord Shiva, and you will sense a tremendous change. You will develop leadership skills, and you'll also get name and fame for what you're doing. You'll get the due recognition for what you've done. So this is the beauty of Bhattabhairav Anushtan. Do reach out to me if you have any of the issues that I mentioned, or any other thing also. If you feel you're able to relate to with this particular Anushtan, you can reach out to me. Thank you so much. Namaste.